You're learning with 9 to 5 English. Business English for the workplace. Hi, Tim here with another 9 to 5 English lesson. In today's lesson, we're going to learn how to talk about where you are from. In the world of business, we have the chance to meet people from all sorts of backgrounds. And one of the most common questions we ask people we've just met is, "Where are you from?" In other words, "Where do you come from?" So, how do you answer that question? Well, we can understand it in two ways. First, it might mean where you grew up. That is, where you lived as a child. One way you can talk about where you grew up is to say you were raised or were born in a certain place. And that place might be a country, a city, or an area of the world. If someone asks where you're from, you can also just use that word, from, in your answer. Like, "I'm from France." And if you grew up in France, but you don't live there now, you might say, "I'm originally from France." Also, if you're talking about which country you're from, you could just say your nationality, such as, "I'm French." How about practicing some of this language? We're going to give you some examples. After you hear each example, try repeating it yourself. Ready? Let's give it a go.
I was raised in a small town in Ohio.
I'm Irish, born and bred.
I'm originally from Santiago.
I was born in Spain, but now I live in France.
We've just practiced some ways of talking about where you grew up. In other words, these are ways to talk about where you are originally from. That's the first meaning of, "Where are you from?" But the second meaning of this question is, "Where do you live now?" After all, in the 21st century, many people don't live and work in the same place they grew up. One way to answer the question is simply to say, "I live and work in such and such a place." That's a clear and direct answer. You might also say, "I've got a place in a certain city." A place, in this case, means a home, as in a house or an apartment. So, for example, you might say, "I've got a little place in London." That idea of home can also be used in an answer. You can say that you call a certain place home. For example, when someone asks where you're from, and they mean where you currently live, you can say, "I call London home." That expression lets people know that you haven't always lived there, but you do now. In this situation, you might even let people know how long you've lived in that place. For example, you might say, "I've been in London for the past 5 years." Now it's your turn to try using these expressions. You'll hear some examples. After each example, repeat what you hear. Let's begin.
I live and work just outside of London.
I've got a place in downtown San Diego.
These days, I call Seattle home.
I've been in Berlin for the past 10 years or so.
So, as we've seen, the question, "Where are you from?" can be answered in two ways. It might mean, "Where did you grow up?" Or it might mean, "Where do you live now?" Usually, you can understand from the situation what someone means when they ask that question. And sometimes, people want to know both where you grew up and where you live. Okay, we've done a bit of practice with some useful expressions, but how does this sound in a conversation? Let's listen to a short discussion between Dave and Julie to find out.
So, are you originally from New York?
No, I was actually raised in a small town near Chicago.
Interesting. But now you call New York home?
That's right. I've got a place in Queens.
Can you see how that worked? Dave first wants to know where Julie grew up, which she explains with the expression, "I was raised in a place." Then he wants to know where she lives. And she says she's got a place in a certain part of New York. Now it's your turn to practice. We'll repeat the dialogue, but this time we're going to beep out Julie's words. You will have to say those parts yourself. Remember, first you'll say, "You were raised near Chicago." Then you'll say, "You've got a place in Queens." Here we go.
So, are you originally from New York? Interesting. But now you call New York home?
All right. So we've learned a few different ways to talk about where you're from. That includes where you grew up and where you live now. In our next lesson, we'll learn how to talk about your educational background. Until then, so long and happy learning.